This Italian company makes exact reproductions of the renowned Winchesters, produced in the United States starting in 1866. These lever actions were a game changer in that era because they did away with having to reload your rifle one cartridge at a time. To make the barrel, the long tube through which the ammunition shoots, the factory starts with a bar of solid steel that's 27 millimeters in diameter. A computer-guided circular saw slices it into barrel-length pieces. Next, a computer-guided drill bores through the center of each barrel-length bar. The drill is fluted. This provides a channel for a continuous high-pressure flow of cutting oil, which breaks down the metal shavings as the drill advances from one end of the bar to the other over the course of 5 minutes. A reamer gradually widens the bore to the required diameter. This takes 15 minutes. The diameter of the barrel is what determines a firearm's caliber. A rifle gets its name from the next operation. This specialized tool rifles the barrel, meaning it carves spiraled grooves into the barrel bore's smooth walls. This process takes twice as long as drilling and reaming combined. The grooves in the barrel put a spin on the cartridge's bullet as it exits the gun. Like the perfect pass of a football, this spin stabilizes the bullet, rendering it more aerodynamic. That makes the shot more accurate over a long distance. The next machine mills the outside of the barrel. This particular model has an octagonal barrel, so the machine mills 8 sides. Another machine then makes threads on the back end, so the barrel can later screw into the adjacent part of the rifle. A local foundry, meanwhile, forges the rifle's lever. Workers feed solid steel bars into a small furnace. The furnace temperature, a blazing 1200 degrees Celsius, softens the steel in a matter of seconds. While the bar is still red hot, they place it in a die and stamp it with a press to bend it. Then 2 more pressings in a different die to form the bent bar into the basic shape of the lever. A 4th pressing against a razor-sharp die this time trims the perimeter. The roughly shaped lever is now ready for machining in the rifle factory. There, a computer-guided mill works at it for 8 minutes, meticulously shaving off bits of steel until the lever's shape is perfected. The mechanical section of the rifle is called the action. Like the lever, it's forged out of a steel bar. Then over the course of an hour, machined to specifications by 100 different computer-guided tools. This operation not only finalizes the action's external shape, it also hollows out areas for the internal components, namely the rifle's lever-activated loading and firing mechanism. But before that assembly happens, the action takes a side trip to a metal treatment plant, where it undergoes a 2-step process. First, 3 minutes submerged in a hot water bath with special salts which harden the steel. Then a quick dip in a 2nd bath containing a coloring chemical. This gives the steel an antique finish. The action now returns to the gun factory to rejoin the rifle's other components. To assemble the rifle's firing mechanism, workers first attach the trigger and the hammer spring to a larger component called the trigger guard. Then they connect the hammer itself with a tight-fitting pin. The hammer spring provides the resistance needed for the hammer to hit the firing pin hard enough to fire the cartridge after it's cocked. Taking the action, they insert the bolt containing the firing pin, then the firing pin extension. This wedge piece links those two components. They insert the trigger guard into the action, coaxing it into the correct position with a few taps of a mallet. They attach the lever underneath the trigger guard. They mount a spring on each side of the lever to put tension on it. Then finally, they connect the lever to the firing mechanism with two sets of links. To cock the hammer and prepare to pull the trigger to fire, you pull down the lever, then pull it back up. After firing, you move the lever up and down once again to eject the spent cartridge and reload and cock for the next shot. They finish assembling the action by attaching side plates, one of which has a side-loading gate for inserting the cartridges. The action has two threaded holes, one for attaching the magazine tube that holds the cartridges, and the other for attaching the barrel. Its threaded end requires some top filing in order to meet the very strict specifications set out by the proof house, the body responsible for ensuring that firearms conform to all manufacturing regulations. To attach the barrel to the action, they lock the barrel in a vise, then screw the action onto the threaded end. They use various tools and gauges to ensure the two parts are perfectly aligned and that the lever closes completely when pulled up. Next, they insert what's called a check cartridge of the appropriate caliber into the chamber. This checks the internal spacing to ensure the ammunition feeds correctly and fires safely. They mount a temporary stock on the other end of the action and send the rifle to the proof house for performance and safety testing. There, technicians place it in an enclosed chamber, load ammunition, and fire twice. The proof house hand punches markings onto the bottom of the rifle. These markings, recognized by the European Economic Community, officially certify that the firearm functions properly and safely. The gun factory contracts a woodworking company to produce the rifle's stock. It's made from a block of walnut. First, workers trace a template that's in the basic shape of the stock. They saw along the trace line. This gives them a starting form, which computer-guided machines then refine. A mill progressively carves the detailed profile with a series of different tools. Then they mount the stock on a lathe, which rotates it against a sander to smooth the surface and perfect the shape. The stock has two holes in the back, to which they attach an end piece. The wood shop stains and varnishes the finished stock and sends it to the gun factory, where workers attach it to the action. After that, they mount the magazine tube to the action. When you feed cartridges into the side loading gate, they drop into the magazine tube. Upon levering the rifle, a carrier pushes up one cartridge, which the bolt then pushes into the chamber, preparing the rifle to fire.